six, a helping hand with your land.
Neil from Messix here with one of the new Cub Cadet Pro Z 900 zero turn mowers. It has duals. The fact that this mower has duals should tell you that it's a little different than your typical zero turn mower. There's a handful of things that sets this mower apart from your typical zero turn mower. Cub Cadet actually gives a slope rating for this machine. If you know anything about zero turn mowers, you talk to a couple guys that own one, you'll find out very quickly that zero turn mowers don't do real well on hillsides. Cub Cadet's line is a little bit different because of some of the features and the way they have their steering system set up. They hold hillsides better than most typical zero-turn mowers do, and by adding things like duals to the back end, it does even better. If you go through the literature on this, they'll actually okay this one at a 45-degree angle on a hillside, so a really steep, solid hillside, a place that I certainly wouldn't feel comfortable with a lot of zero-turn mowers. This one is able to go there. So this thing can get hillside stability with those dual tires, but it also gets hillside stability by the way that its front steering is set up. Most zero turn mowers are going to have caster wheels in the front that are free spinning wheels. As you go into tight turns and spin yourself around, they just point whichever way the machine wants to go. That becomes problematic on a hillside. If you run across a hill, the front end of a machine on a zero turn mower is always going to want to run downhill on you. Now, you can compensate for some of that by running your downhill tire a little bit faster, but it certainly doesn't give you a good sense of stability or allow you to track a really steep hill when that caster wheel is always wanting to turn and run on you. Cub Cadet's line of mowers with steering wheels on them work a little bit differently. These front tires actually steer and they go the whole way around to the sharp angles required in order to do a zero turn. They work a little bit differently. At the base of the steering column down here, there's a gear set that turns. When you turn this steering wheel, it's turning those front tires and helping that front end of the machine to steer. So you get that kind of zero turn effect that you can from a zero turn mower, but with the hillside stability of a traditional tractor. So you can see here as I drive across this hill just how these front wheels are gonna help me make this tricky downhill turn. On a regular zero turn mower, especially if this grass was wet, this would be a maneuver you'd want to be very careful about. When you make turns like this, it's pretty easy for a mower to break loose and slide. But the way these front steering tires work, when I get up here to the edge and I turn downhill, they stop me from sliding and running off, right? They hold the machine back as I turn with that added traction from those big dual tires on the back. I bet this is steep, I'll tell you. You get this seat of the pants feeling when you're doing things that you shouldn't be doing, and I don't get that, right? Like, you feel a sense of stability as this thing goes back and forth, and as I do these kind of complicated weaves back and forth on this hillside, I'm fine.
Generally, we're really cautious about putting duals onto machines because of the added stress that it can be put back on a machine's transmission housing. And if you've seen the wheel motors and stuff that are on zero turn mowers, you'll notice that they're generally aluminum casings with some fairly small axles and stuff coming out of the side. Not something that I would ever look at and think is a good idea to put duals on. But this is a little bit different. There is the transmission in the wheel here has an actual axle housing sitting back against the frame of the machine, giving that drive system some additional stability to be able to support the loads that those tires could put on the machine when you're on these steep hillsides.
This is a surprisingly comfortable mower to operate. If I'm sitting here, I have an air ride seat on this, something that's only found on the most high end of zero turn mowers. By sitting here and adjusting this little switch with the key turned on, you can inflate or deflate the airbags underneath the seat in order to give this thing a really smooth ride. Makes a big difference over a spring suspension. One further upgrade that's available on this machine though that's not on this one is a different undercarriage underneath the seat here that allows this seat to stay level and rotate with the hillside. So if you were out on this machine and literally cutting hills all day long rather than leaning the entire time to hold your body straight, this would actually allow the seat here itself in order to rotate with the hillside and stay level. Now, that is not an inexpensive option. It adds $3,500 to the list price of this $17,000 machine. Now, if we're totally honest, Cub Cadet is probably not the first company that comes to mind when you start thinking about commercial zero-turn mowers. Many, many people are very familiar with this brand in more residential products, but they make this high-end stuff as well. When we go around the machine here and we kind of look at some of its features and construction, it is pretty clear that this is a proper commercial-grade mower. The deck is made of 7-gauge steel. It's obvious a lot of engineering thought was put into things like these steering systems and giving you tilt steering, things for comfort. The engine that's on this is a 35-horse Kawasaki FX1000 engine, and that 35-horse coming from Kawasaki is an honest 35-horse, a little bit different than what comes from a lot of the other engine manufacturers. The lift here to bring the mower deck up and down can very simply be done with this electronic power lift switch. You've got dual fuel tanks on both sides, cup holders, legit good strong levers for your parking brake, and this awesome seat. So while Cub is not necessarily the commercial mower of choice a lot of times, if you've got an application like this that you need this hillside type machine, the construction is all here in a way that you should be pretty impressed by. Here at Messick's, we're a vendor for literally 7 different lines of zero-turn mowers. And while that seems like a lot, each one of those companies has some niche products like this that when we go in and dive into particular customers' applications, we're gonna find people who need to do tricky things like mow hillsides and wanting to do it with a zero-turn mower. And it's cool to have the selection of vendors that gives us the opportunity to pick and choose those special products from the different companies that we offer. And this is clearly a little out of the box for a zero-turn mower, not something that we see from a lot of these other vendors. So if you have an application like this that you need these extreme hillside mowing type applications done, we've got a lot of different solutions to do those kinds of things. Give us a call at Messick's. We're available at 800-222-3373 or online at Messick's.com.